Gito. Our topic for today is about illustrates the measures of central tendency, which are the mean, median, and mode of a statistical graph. A measure of central tendency, also referred to as measures of centroidy or central location, is a summary measure that attempts to describe a whole set of data with a single value that represents the middle or centroidy of its distribution. There are three main measures of central tendency. These are the mode, the median, and the mean. Each of these measures describes a different indication of the typical or central value in the distribution. Okay, the first measure of central tendency is the mean, also known as the arithmetic. It is the sum of the value of each observation in a data set divided by the number of observations. Example: consider this data set showing the retirement age of 11 people in 2 years. 54, 54, 54, 55, 56, 57, 57, 58, 58, 60, and 60. Now, this table shows a simple frequency distribution of the retirement age data. The mean is calculated by adding together all the values 54 plus 54 plus 54 plus 55 plus 56 plus 57 plus 57 plus 58 plus 58 plus 60 plus 60 equals 623, and dividing by the number of observations, which is 11, which equals to 56.6 years. The advantage of the mean is the mean can be used for both continuous and discrete numeric data. Limitations of the mean: the mean cannot be calculated for categorical data as the values cannot be summed. As the mean includes every value in the distribution, the mean is influenced by outliers and skewed distributions. The second measure of central tendency is the median. The median is the middle value in the distribution when the values are arranged in ascending or descending order. The median divides the distribution in half. There are 50% of observations on either side of the median value. In a distribution with an odd number of observations, the median value is the middle. Looking at the retirement age distribution, which has 11 observations, the median is the middle value, which is 57 years. So that's the median. Now, when the distribution has an even number of observations, the median value is the mean of the two middle values. In the following distribution, the two middle values are 56 and 57. Therefore, we need to get the mean of the two middle values. 56 plus 57 divided by 2 is equal to 56.5 years. Therefore, the median is 56.5 years. The advantage of the median is that the median is less affected by outliers and skewed data than the mean, and is usually the preferred measure of central tendency when the distribution is not symmetrical. Limitations of the median: the median cannot be identified by or for categorical nominal data, as it cannot be logically ordered. The last measure of central tendency is the mode. The mode is the most commonly occurring value in a distribution. Looking at the retirement age distribution again, 54, 54, 54, 55, 56, 57, 57, 58, 58, 60, and 60, the value that occurs most commonly is 54. So the most commonly occurring value is 54. Therefore, the mode of this distribution is 54 years. Now, the advantage of the mode. The mode has an advantage over the median and the mean as it can be found for both numerical and categorical. Limitations of the mode. There are some limitations to using the mode for the same distribution of data, or bimodal or multimodal. The presence of more than one mode can limit the ability of the mode in describing the century or typical value of the distribution, because a single value to describe the century cannot be identified. In some cases, particularly where the measure where the data are continuous, the distribution may have no mode at all. In cases such as these, it may be better to consider using the median or mean, or group the data into appropriate intervals and find the middle class. Okay, thank you for watching.